Hello everyone, today we are going to do next topic, numbers on the abacus. Now let's see how we write the numbers on the abacus. Tens and ones, these numbers we have to mention on the abacus. This is an abacus. Here we see two sticks are given, okay, and on the two sticks some beads are also given. Stick on the right side, this is the right side which shows the ones, and stick on the left side shows the tens. So these are the ones and these are the tens. Here we write the numbers at the ones place and here we write the numbers at the tens place after counting the beads. If I say, as you know, that this one complete is one, one is written as O N E O. This is one and it is shown as, this is shown on the abacus. आपको पता है one one is known as one. तो here one bead is shown at the ones place and no bead is shown at the tens place. So the number is only one. We count only one. So here we'll be writing 1 and here we'll be writing 0 because no bead is given here. Okay. Now let's see how we write the tens. Now here, next you see that it is written here 10 ones or 110. That means 10 ones is written as 10 and is shown on abacus as like this. As you can see here, at the tens place only one bead is given and no bead is given at the ones place. That is, tens means 10 ones means 110. That means it is 1 and this is 0. We have no beads at the ones place. Here it will become 0 and here it will write 1. So 1 0 10, these are the ones. This is the one in which we'll be writing 1 at the ones place, 0 here at the tens place, and at the tens. And how we write 10? This is 10 and this is 1. So 1 0 10. Now let us see more numbers, that how we can count and write the correct numbers on the abacus. Here you can see one example is given. At the tens place we have 2 beads and at the ones place we have, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. That means this spikes show 2 and this spike or stick shows 6. So the complete number is 26. Likewise, you can count here, start from ones. How many beads are there on this stick? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So here 5 will come. And how many beads are there? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So here 4 will come. That means the correct number is 45. Okay. Let us take one more example. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. 8 beads are given. That means 8 will come here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Here 6 beads are there. That means 6 will come here. So the complete number is 68. So likewise, you can count the numbers, count the beads and write the numbers on the abacus. Now next question is, draw the beads on the abacus for the given numbers. Now what you have to do, number is given, you have to draw the beads. Here 33 number is given. So at the ones also you have to draw 1, 2 and 3, 3 beads. And at the tens column also you have to draw the 3 beads, 1, 2 and 3. That will become 33. Now let us take one more example. Here 27 is given. That means at the ones you have to draw 7 beads and at the tens you have to draw 2 beads. Let's draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So 7 beads are drawn. You can write 7 here. Here you have to draw 2 beads. So 1 and 2. So 2 beads are drawn here. You can write here 27. So the correct number is 27. Let's take one more example. Here it is given 9. Only 9 is given. That means no bead will be drawn at the tens place. Only beads will be drawn at the ones place because the number is only 9. So let's draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So here you will be writing 9 and no beads is there on the tens place. So here you will be writing 0. So likewise, you can draw the beads on the abacus for the given numbers. I hope it is clear. Thank you.